to the rest of the country. Households there are being forced to make impossible choices, like deciding to take a malnourished baby to hospital at the expense of feeding the rest of the family. Renewed fighting at Hodeidah's port means deaths for hundreds of thousands of malnourished children, supplies are disrupted. Save the Children say another 1 million children are at risk, bringing the total to over 5 million.
Assistance to 8 million people every month, which is what the World Food Program's target is, in a very complex conflict situation, is very challenging.
The conflict in Yemen has been called the world's forgotten war. That makes its citizens the forgotten people. The UN warned in May that if conditions don't improve, 2/3 of the population could starve by the end of this year.
This is the day. He's 7 months old. He has severe malnutrition. Desperate to help him, his family travelled for weeks from the remote island of Socotra to a hospital here in Yemen's capital, Sana'a. But all the beds are full.
We tried to treat his malnutrition on the islands, but there are no facilities available, no skilled doctors. So we came here to Sana'a.
How long was Sana'a? You know, such as today.
On the journey, he was uncomfortable and sick. When we arrived here, we were surprised to see how crowded it was. They told us to come back another day.
Thank you. I don't like to make anyone sad. Why would I want to make you sad? If I did want to make you sad, I would tell you the story of when we got on the boat. It was very big. When I first saw it, I was afraid. But when I got on the boat, I liked it. I wasn't afraid anymore. Once it moved, water started getting into the boat, and we got sprayed by the water. It felt as if my mother and I might drown, that the boat might go down. Whenever we moved a little, the water splashed on us. And I was dressed like this, exactly like this. I was very, very, very cold. After I got cold, I was very, very, very scared. There was a woman sitting on our bank, and she thought it was hers. She gave it to a man, and he threw it in the sea. All my things in the bag were new. I've only worn them once. I told my mother I want to wear them again. Just in case someone threw our stuff away when we got on the boat. She said, no, my dear, they won't be thrown away. And put them in her bag again, but I was right. They were thrown away. When the sun came out, I looked at my mom. She was sitting in water at the bottom of the boat, so I put her up. Then the fuel ran out and a fisherman with his boat pulled us to shore. Once we got to the shore, we tore the boat through the life vests away and moved on into the mountains. The mountain was very, very high. Every time we reached the peak, I thought it was over, but we continued to go higher. But I swear I don't remember how we slept. I forgot. I don't remember it well. After we got to the road, we cleaned ourselves from the dust and went to the police. After we finished with the police, they told us to go. I miss my school in Syria and I miss my teacher. She was lovely. She never made me sad. I had a little friend. Now I'm living on that. I hope things get back to how they were, and it's always get back to how it was. talk. I don't want to talk. Judging anyone except myself. And what good is that doing anyone? So I thought, felt anxiety. A natural feeling. And I tried to place it. And I found it. Thank you. does collect food for the food pump. So they don't tell you to empty your gurney. So of course you haven't got anything. Talk to the manager. Suggest. Hey, how about having a sign up to tell her? That's quite a big ripple. Because that might extend to the issue wanted. But would I actually do that? Or am I just talking about it? I wasn't going to talk in this session. Each time I'm not using enough paint, I don't feel like I'm honouring that particular child, so I go back. There you are. That's picture this year.